Today we are going to solve one problem based on how to find the damping ratio, okay, natural frequency, expression for output response and all. So let us see the question. For the system shown below, okay, this is the system. Obtain the closed loop transfer function, C of S by R of S we have to get, then damping ratio, then natural frequency as well as the output response if it is subjected to unit step input, okay. So input is given unit step. Now, for that, first we'll go for closed loop transfer function. See, as we know, it is nothing but C of S by R of S. Correct? Transfer function. It is nothing but C of S by R of S. And it is given by G of S by 1 plus G of S into H of S. Since Y plus here, because you can see over here, this is negative feedback. Minus sign is there. Correct? So, you have to give plus. And this is the same formula. If it is positive, then you have to give minus here. That's it. So G of S is nothing but this one, and H of S is unity here, because nothing is there, right? Here no block is there, that means it is unity, that means we have to consider it as 1, okay? So what will happen, G of S is this one, so 20 by S plus 1 into S plus 4, whole thing divided by 1 plus 20, again G of S is there, S plus 1 into S plus 4 into nothing is there, 1. Okay, now I will take here LCM. Okay, so we can take here LCM. So this will become 20 by S plus 1 into S plus 4, whole thing divided by this. You have to multiply here. This will become S plus 1 into S plus 4 plus 20. This is into 1, no need to write. Whole thing divided by S plus 1 into S plus 4. Simple, taking LCM. So this two get cancelled, correct? Here also denominator get cancelled. This you have to simplify. What will happen here? 20 divided by, this is nothing but S square plus 4S plus S plus 4 plus 20. Okay. So this will become 24. This will become 5S. So what will be the final thing? 20 by S square plus 5S plus 20. This will be final C of S by R of S for the given diagram. Okay. So this we got transfer function. First part of the question is over. Now from this, we can easily find out the damping ratio, natural frequency and all. So let us do that. So in order to find out the damping ratio, okay. So we have to go forward. Damping ratio basically means zeta. Okay. Then omega D is the damping frequency of the oscillations. Natural frequency is also there, which is nothing but omega n. All these things we have to find out. For that, we have to consider the standard form of the second order system. So standard form is nothing but C of S by R of S, which is equal to omega n square by S square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. Okay, this you have to consider. Now, while comparing this and this, we get to know that this omega n square and this omega n square is not matching. Here it is 20 and here it is 24. So which one we have to consider? Always remember, some of the cases they will give you which is not in the standard form. So always you have to take the characteristic equation. Characteristic equation basically means the denominator part. So always compare this with this. So whenever you get confused, always you have to consider the denominator part, which is nothing but the characteristic equation. So S square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. You have to compare with this denominator. That's it. Okay. Now, when you compare. So, while comparing, what happens? Omega n square, it is equal to what? 24, right? So, what will happen? Omega n will be, which is nothing but the natural frequency, right? So, it is square root of 24. So, when you try to find out square root of 24, it is equal to approximately 4.8989. radian per second. Unit is very important, omega n. Now next we'll compare 2 zeta omega ns with what is there, 5s. Okay, so s is, no need to compare. Now in this we can substitute omega n value, whatever we got, right? So it will become 2 zeta into omega n value 4.89 into omega n, equal to what, 5. Now zeta value will become, zeta is nothing but the damping ratio. So 5 by 2 into 4.89, right? So zeta value will become 0.51031. Okay, 0.51031. No unit for this. This is the damping ratio. This is the natural frequency. So let us know what else is left. We have to find out. Okay, we found out damping ratio and natural frequency. Now output response we have to find out. Okay, so for the output response we have to find out one more term, which is nothing but omega d, which is called as the damping frequency. Like this is damping, this is natural frequency, this is damping frequency. It is given by omega n into 1 minus zeta square root of that. So which is equal to omega n value we have 4.8989 into 1 minus zeta value is 0.51031 square. So it is equal to 4.2129 radian per second. Unit is important. Okay, so this is omega d. Now we'll go for the C of t, which is nothing but the output response. The formula is 1 minus e power minus zeta omega n t by 1 minus zeta square into sine omega dt plus theta. Okay, now here in this we have to find out one more term, which is theta. Okay, so we have found out this zeta, omega n and omega d. Now we are left with theta. T will remain as it is. Okay, this is C of t function, so t will remain as it is. Now theta formula, we have tan inverse of 1 minus zeta square by zeta, so which is nothing but you have to substitute tan inverse of 1 minus zeta square, means this value zeta square you have to do 0.51031 the whole square by divided by 0.51031. so when you substitute these values you will get the theta value as 1.03 in radians. You will get, remember this, in radians, not in degrees. So theta value we got. Now you have to substitute all these values. Before that, one more thing you have to remember, that since the C of s by R of s value is not given in standard form, as you can see here, this is, as I said before, 20 and this is 24. This is not in standard form. You have to make this as what? 24, right? See, always you have to consider this this one only, okay? Not this one. Denominator, whatever characteristic function equation is there, based on that, this is 24, so this should be 24. Okay, always you have to, with respect to denominator, you have to see. Now, since we have to, I have to make this as 24, so let me just write it. C of s by R of s, which is equal to 20 by s square plus 5s plus 24. Okay, so I need to make here 24. So I'll multiply with 24 and divide it by the 24. Okay, multiply and divide by 24. Now 20 and 24 I'll take it outside, so I'll write it as 20 by 24 and inside it will be 24 by s square plus 5s plus 24. So now it is in what? Standard form. This equation, you can see this is in what? Standard form. So what is the extra term here? It is 20 by 24. So this extra term I have to multiply here, 20 by 24, that is the thing. So before, like if it is not given in standard form, always try to make it as in the standard form and take the extra term and multiply here in this C of t function. That is important step. Okay, now C of t will become what? C of t is equal to 20 by 24, which is the extra term I have to multiply. So inside 1 minus e power minus zeta, so I'll first write it this one, zeta omega n t by 1 minus zeta square into sine omega dt plus theta. Okay, so all the values we got. Okay, all the values we got. Now we have to just substitute. So we have got here, you can see all the values. Zeta is there, omega n value we got, omega d, correct, this one, then theta value we got at last. So all the values substituting in this equation. So when I substitute, this will become 20 by 24 into 1 minus e power zeta into omega, correct. So zeta value we have 0.5001, just multiply and write, okay, into omega n, omega n, then we have 4.89, okay, into t, divided by 1 minus zeta square, again zeta 0.5 0, 1, 3, that thing in whole square you have to do, into sine omega dt, omega d value we got it as 4.2129, into t will remain as it is, plus theta value is 1.03. okay, now simplifying all these equations, I will get it as 20/24 into 1 minus 1.1628 e power minus 2.5 t sine 4.2129 t plus 1 point. Okay, you can just simplify this, and this basically I have simplified this and taken to the numerator part. 1 by that value I have written here, okay, 1.1628. you can just simplify. I have already simplified that value, I have written directly over here. Okay, that's the thing. So c of t, you will get it as this. So always remember this additional term, you have to multiply, that is the thing.